So tell me, Vasu, about how you're approaching a Chinese or an emerging markets portfolio at the moment. We've had plenty of people that have come on and said, well, they're just simply uninvestable. You don't want to take the risk. There's too much opacity when it comes to policy. What's your view?
We're not far from that. I mean, we kind of agree with some of those views that have been, you know, expounded by other interviewees of yours, because, you know, there's still a lack of clarity, policy clarity, as far as China is concerned. So China is facing a triple whammy. Its economy is slowing down, for one. You've got a regulatory crackdown. And, you know, the policy, as far as that's concerned, is rather opaque at this juncture. And, of course, you've got the Evergrande saga. So it's a triple whammy. And, you know, I think that's spooking investors. We still have no clarity as far as Evergrande is concerned. We still have no clarity as far as regulatory crackdown is concerned. As far as the economy is concerned, the authorities have indicated they could provide some monetary and fiscal policy support. Then they've not done anything exceptional. So given that sort of backdrop, given so much of uncertainty, you know, we're telling our clients, look, I mean, yes, Chinese equities have pulled back very sharply from the peak in mid-February this year. They may look attractive, but if you do, you know, tread into Chinese equities, move very cautiously. I mean, this is not the time to buy aggressively because, you know, there's still uncertainty at this juncture, and we're not sure when that's going to clear up just yet.
The associated sell-off that we saw, particularly in the US, does that tell you more about the levels of how overbought these markets are, how high these valuations are, that Evergrande may just be the catalyst to a bit of much-needed rebalancing?
Well, you know, you're right. I mean, the equity markets have done exceptionally well. I mean, the US stock market has been the leader. But if you pick global equities, MSCI World Index is up almost 96% from the bottom in March of last year. That's a lot. But at the same time, if you look at the price earnings valuations, yes, they're not compelling. They're not, you know, screaming buy right now. But neither are they exceptionally expensive. You don't have irrational exuberance in the markets. Yes, so and there's a lot of liquidity on the sidelines. So yes, Evergrande comes in at a time when the markets are nervous, having doubled, you know, equity values having doubled in the last 18 months or so. So understandable, Evergrande has provided an excuse for investors to, you know, focus a bit more on the negatives, take some profit and cost-created market volatility. But we don't think that the medium-term upside is negative. I mean, we're actually quite sanguine on the medium-term upside. But, you know, in the next few weeks and perhaps even the next couple of months, Evergrande, coupled with FOMC, the Delta variant, and a host of other issues, will continue to create volatility. And, you know, to some extent, the volatility may be a buying opportunity.
Vasu, we continue to hear that ongoing debate whether or not this could be China's Lehman moment. This is what Ray Dalio had to say and where he stands on whether or not this is a Lehman moment. Take a listen.
The Lehman moment produced pervasive structural damage through the system that wasn't rectified until the Treasury came across in terms of its borrowing, and then the Fed came across with quantitative easing. But this is not that kind of a shake-up type of thing. This is $300 billion is what they owe, and this is all manageable.
He says that China is a strategy play. Do you agree? And you mentioned some opportunities perhaps in the long term. Where do you see that?
Well, firstly, you know, I agree with him, you know, that this is not a Lehman moment, because if you look at the, you know, interest-bearing liabilities of Evergrande, it's only, you know, less than 1% of Chinese banking system loans. So it's very, very low right now. Even indirectly, if you look at the Chinese banking system, I mean, exposure to property developers, exposure to construction companies, which are linked to property developers, it's, you know, somewhere in the region of 9% or so, something that's quite manageable. So I don't think this is a systemic problem. Most of the loans of Evergrande are domestic loans. They're not international loans. I mean, you do have some US dollar bonds, but most of it is domestic. So I don't think this is a Lehman moment. I think this is something that China can manage, will manage. But nevertheless, you know, Beijing has been mum about what it plans to do. And I think that's going to create nervousness. And yes, China is a strategic play. But if you do buy China with a strategic view, I think you have to buy very cautiously and very gradually. I mean, there's no hurry to jump in and lump sum trade the markets right now.
So given our focus on Evergrande and the concerns there, it seems that the FOMC has sort of faded to the background. What should Asian investors be watching out for, given that we do have the Fed policy decision now?
Well, you know, clearly the FOMC is faded in the background, but it will come back to the forefront, you know, in the next 24 hours or so. And essentially, I think what will investors want to look out for? Two things. Number one, whether the Fed is going to indicate it's going to taper soon, whether the Fed is going to indicate how much it will taper by. But most importantly, I think, will be the dot plot. The markets will be keeping a very close eye on the dot plot, because what happened at the last FOMC was, you know, expectations of interest rates were brought forward. Previously, the Fed was looking at no interest rate hike in 2023. Last meeting, we saw the dot plot move, Fed governors seeing interest rate hikes in 2023. The question is, will they see interest rate hikes taking place in 2022? This is what the markets fear about, that, you know, interest rate expectations are going to be brought forward. If that happens, that's going to spook the markets. But if it doesn't, that may provide the market some degree of comfort.